So hello again. In this episode, we will be adding DataScript into our project, right? So DataScript, the plan is that it will keep every bit of state about our game. And basically, each time the DataScript database changes, we update our screen and we render current state. So that's the idea. In terms of entity component system, entities in DataScript will be entities from entity component system, and attributes will be like kind of components, something like that. So adding DataScript is kind of simple, really. So we go to devs.eden, but I already have DataScript here, right? Then we require DataScript.core SD, actually SDS. Yeah, I should be using DS. Okay, and after that we need dev. Well, actually we need something like con. I'm going to call it startDB, which means atom that contains DB. And usually I would be using something like that. Okay, one more thing. So we need also a schema, but in our case, schema will be empty, okay? And this should create a database. Okay, let's save and see if everything is all right. Oops, it's probably already compiled, right? Okay, it's probably already compiled. So anyways, and now we have reactive mix in here, right? So basically we do this. This is strange. Why do we have reactive? So we have reactive, but we don't react to anything. But anyways, so database is going to be our first reactive component, really, and we are going to use ram react, and this accepts atom. Luckily for us, connection for DataScript is atom as well, so basically this works kind of as deref, but it also sets up a listener that on each change will re-render this component. So basically, if we, let me just do println render here, okay? So let's say that we will have a field in a different component like this, and it will accept DB, right? But in our case, it will just render. So it's basically it's top-down render. Each time database changes, we render from the very top. The same as this happens when scale changes, right? So that's it. Let's save. Let's go here. So something is wrong or not wrong. So we see render twice. Okay, let's we see it here as well. So db here is main/startDB, right? So let's see, db is empty. So let's script core transact startDB. Let's add something, right? So db add one name, so it won't change anything, so but basically we transact and we see immediately the render was called basically, and then here we can see the render was called, so it rendered everything. So now we have our database set up in such a way so that every change will basically trigger re-render, right? And the only thing here that I will probably change right now, so right now we have nothing, right? But we will probably have some initial state, so let's say initial text will be our minus one name one. Okay, so just for example, right? So how do you pass this? So the trick is you can call of course ds transact db initial text, right? But I don't really like that the code that executes when your namespace gets evaluated. So normally, like evaluating namespace should be idempotent operation, but invoking except for def and defense, of course, right? So, but basically, what we need here is we need to create a database with schema, then transact this data in it, and then create a connection from it. So to do that, we are going to do this. So it will be DS empty DB with schema, right? And okay, you can actually have a name attribute here, it doesn't really matter. Then we will say DB with, right? And pass initial tick. So basically, so we start create an empty database, not a connection, but a database that is like a mutable database, right? Then we create a new database which uses this initial state with this transaction and returns a new database. And then we have conf from DB, if I remember correctly. So yes, let's see. Yeah, renders code, and if we print this database, we can see that the initial state is already in there, right? And it doesn't matter right now. So for example, if I just change and this gets re-evaluated, it doesn't matter that much. Normally also I would probably do def once here, so that database like initialize once, and your state doesn't get destroyed when the code changes, right? If you made some moves, right, then they don't roll back to the initial position. But for now, while we're developing this game, I will keep it as def, because like we are not going to change it really. We are going to change initial transaction probably and schema probably much more often. So we have to recreate this database from scratch over and over. But that's it. Yeah, that's how you set up your application on using DataScript. Maybe like, yeah, the smarter way to do that would be if each component will only render, component will only render if data that it directly relates to changes, right? And this is not our case. In our case, everything renders. And this is okay, because like in games, you normally have to be able to re-render the whole screen in 16 milliseconds, otherwise your game won't work, because of animations, for example, right? Because lots of stuff happens every frame in a game, and it always changes, so it doesn't really matter if we trigger it reactively or not. If we wouldn't trigger it reactively, we would probably just re-render each frame, so it doesn't really matter how we do that. But yeah, in our cases, this works as well. And we don't spend like extra cycles if nothing changes. So that's good, at least. Okay, that's it for today. And in the next episode, I will try to build some schema, I guess, for our initial state. See you next time. Bye-bye.